Go away. Really, none of them can let you use their phone? Well, tell them that you need to use their phone again. And FYI, next time mom gives you a time limit, take advantage of that. You knew the time that it was coming. Girls, Christina, Mickey. Christina, Mickey. Jack, I gave you a time limit. Right now, I'm trying to work. I told you, you had 10 minutes, and I was taking my TV and my phone. Christina, Mickey. Don't ignore me, please. Children, what are you going to do? Please help him turn the show on that he wants to watch for me. I know, but he's changed his mind, and I would like you to please help him turn on a different one. Good evening, everybody. So, if you're watching this now, you're probably watching this in replay, but that's okay because this video will be available for shopping until 7 p.m. tomorrow. That is 7 p.m. Mountain Standard Time until Thursday, July 16th. So you can shop this show anytime from now until Thursday, 7 p.m. Mountain Standard Time. Until Thursday. I think you said that. Okay. If you've shopped with me before, you know that I'm doing a monthly giveaway. Originally, I had announced that the winner of this month's giveaway would win one piece of a set with first option to buy the rest of the set. But then I realized, wait a minute, if I actually get any male customers watching my show, I haven't yet, that I know of, that haven't said anything if they've been on here, then I'm basically excluding them, saying, hey, you don't matter, I don't care what you like. If you win, you're going to get a pair of girls' jewelry, right? So I have amended the giveaway to say that the winner will receive one free piece of their choice. So the set that you saw originally pictured for the giveaway is for sale. And you can buy a piece of it today if you want. So everything in our regular line is $5 a piece, plus tax and shipping. We do have a Z collection line, which is more expensive, higher quality pieces. Those are $25 a piece. I only have one of those available. If you'd like to see that, then I can show that to you. And then we have the Little Diva or Starlight Shimmer line, which is $1 a piece.
It says door.
I don't currently plan on showing any of those pieces tonight, but if you come on and you would like to see one, just let me know, and I will show them to you. Let's go ahead and get started here with number one. This piece is new. I have not shown it before on here. And it is going to be number one. Okay, so your free earrings on here are these gold ovals. They're free standing in there. Not connected. They're very lightweight. Gonna hang about like that. Now the necklace has a lobster claw and chain extender, and it comes down into this collection of circles. I have my stand right here so I can show you. Or not circles, ovals. They're ovals. So we got some smooth ones here, varying sizes and thickness. And then we have these ones right here that have the beaten metal. And like some of them, like these really thin ones, there's two ovals on one ring. And then we have this one that is super thick. Okay. Okay, so that is number one. Number two, I have these earrings for you here. They are gold circles, and they are surrounded by white. Well, okay. It is a gold circle with an inner lining of white rhinestones. So they're not surrounded, they're lined on the inside. And the gold has that crisscross pattern, maybe a leather print pattern, you might call it. And those are number two They're very lightweight. They're going to hang about like that. Number two. I think that ring goes with something else. I don't think I have a ring that would... That ring, I think... Yeah, I'm sure it goes with that set right there. Okay, so... Number three... is going to be this... gold bangle. It's connected on the ends. And then you got three stripes. And it's just open back there. This is on the larger side, I would say. I almost think I had to put it on the side of my wrist for it to go on. And that's number three. That is a bigger one. Got larger wrists. That's going to fit very well. I'm going to hear something exciting. My nephew, his girlfriend, pregnant, and she had her baby last night, so I'm a great aunt. I'm gonna do something here real quick, hope nobody minds, not that there's anybody here to mind, cause there's just not. Never mind, I can't do that. I didn't get accepted into the group. They have these groups for live videos. And I was accepted into one. But on that one, you can only have, only somebody else can share your video. Can't share your own video. Which is kind of silly if you ask me, but. The rules are the rules. And I suppose we must obey the rules, right? Because if we don't, then it's just anarchy all over the place. Number four. Your free earrings on this necklace are these silver flat discs. And they kind of got lines across them. Oh, so you can see it there. The necklace has a lobster claw chain extender, and it comes down, separates into two separate chains, and you've got this collection of discs. So let's concentrate on this side here. This first one is silver, then you got this one, copper, silver, copper, okay, and the little one. You got copper first, silver, copper, and it just continues like that all the way around. You end up with this beautiful line of discs. And look, the colors even kind of line up. So you get copper, copper, silver, silver, copper, copper. And that is number four. That was actually a set, number five. So I have a perfectly matched, actually this was the one that I originally said was for the giveaway, except now it's one free piece of your choice if you win. And this next one I won't be doing live. I'll just draw the name off camera, announce it live, and send a message to the person who wins. You know what? The ones I said on there that were silver are actually gold. All I was thinking. Right? Yeah. Oh my god. I totally screwed this one up. Okay, so let me correct myself real quick. Okay, so the earrings are gold. The first one is gold, and then we got the copper. If you look at them in the right light, they look silver, but they're not. Maybe that one is silver. Yeah, okay. So, the outer one goes copper, gold. And the inner one goes copper, silver. Remember, that one is number four. Okay, so back to what we were doing. The perfectly matched earrings to this necklace. Number five. They are fishhook earrings on a gold setting. And we start gold, copper, silver. Those same discs that are on the necklace with the same scratch marks across them. And you're going to get lots of noise when you wear these because see, they're attached by that little ring. So they're going to jingle. You will jingle. They're going to hang about like that. They're, I would say, probably medium in weight. So you're going to notice them a little bit. But hey, if you wear these and tell somebody I'll be there with bells on, you can say, well, it's kind of like bells. Sounds like bells, right? Number five. I should not have worn a t-shirt. Should have worn a tank top. Because I'm hot. Okay, number six. This is a perfectly matched bracelet set. Okay? There are five bracelets in this set. They don't open at all. They just slip right over your hand. Take this one right here. It has three gold beads and then a little gold disc hanging from it. I want to make sure I'm telling you the right colors because, man, I got tricked on that last one, didn't I? Come here. Come here. Okay, I'm pretty sure they're gold. So, two gold discs and three beads on that one. Okay, and then you have three with nothing on them. Just three gold bangles. And this bangle right here has two gold beads and I'm pretty sure that's a silver disc. I don't know why I'm having such trouble telling between silver and gold on these little discs. Maybe I bet it's because of the light reflecting off of it. Maybe I can just turn the light off. Number six. Maybe that would be less confusing for me. The light was not shining on it. Am I too dark? I think I'll be okay. What do you think? I don't know if I like it. Any better with the light off. I think I'm going to turn the light back on. I know what you're thinking. Make up your mind, Nancy. What are we doing? Alright? Okay. Number 7. This is a perfectly matched ring to the set. It has got a... Yeah, I've been calling these medium, but I don't really know if they are medium. I don't know if they get any larger. But we're going to stick with a medium stretchy back in gold. And then it's got this gold oval on the front with the same scratch marks or lines that you find in all the discs on the bracelet, earrings, and necklace. All of our rings have the stretchy back. They all fit roughly sizes 6 to 9. And look about like that on. And that is number 7. The dogs are going gaga over something. Who knows what, because they're dogs and they go crazy. Now, number 8. I had this hanging with that last set. I don't know why. I don't know what I was thinking. I think maybe I forgot that it had the matching bracelet already that perfectly matched with it. But it is a set of 3 stretchy bracelets. 2 of them just have these silver beads on them. Very simple. The third one has these brown beads with these silver, I want to call them river rock shape, because you know how they're a little funky shape, sometimes maybe a triangle, sometimes not. Okay, so a set of 3 stretchy bracelets, number 8. Number 9, your free earrings on this necklace are these tiny little copper beads. The necklace has a lobster claw chain extender. You got a double link here in every space. And it comes down into this collection of beads. You have a silver one with gold chicken wire type stuff on it, fauceted copper, another silver, and there's a larger fauceted copper bead. So it just has a collection of beads like that all the way around. It's going to look about like that on. And if you like necklaces like this, I have seen them in other colors. I don't have any. But if you like necklaces like this, just maybe this color isn't your thing, you could let me know and I could try and get one of the other colors. This one is number 9. I don't know who's here. It says somebody's here. Tell me hello. Talk to me. Number 10 is a perfectly matched bracelet. It has the lobster claw and chain extender, and it does have the double links. And it's got the same collection of beads hanging from it that you find on the necklace. So you got a silver bead, faceted copper, silver. You got the silver with the gold chicken wire. It's another faceted copper. Like I said, it's designed to match perfectly with the necklace I just showed. And that is number 10. Well, they came and they went and they didn't say hello. Now we will never know who it was. Number 11. Decided to match it with this ring here. You got the medium stretchy back here. And then on the front, in copper, and on the front, we got these black stones, this copper grill work. Look at the shine you're going to get off of that. Even it's kind of blue right there. But they are black. And that is number 11. Trying to think of something I can really talk to you about, you know, my life or whatnot, but nothing has really happened today. Yeah, I did a little housework. I let the chickens out. That's about it. Number 12. This, I also believe, is one of the new pieces. Let's see, I chaired them on Sunday, so I don't really remember what they were. But we have gold tassel earrings here for your free earrings. The necklace has a lobster claw and chain extender. And it comes down into this pendant. Three different squares. I guess the way they're hanging, they're more like diamonds. And they all have the beaten metal look on them. And they're all independent. They're not connected with each other. So this one, I'm gonna fit about like that. And that is number 12. I had quite a few of my new pieces sell out before I did it live. I had three of my new pieces sell before I did this show. Okay, yeah, that last piece was a new one. It was. Okay. Next few pieces I put together for you are very... Oh, wait. See, I started looking at something else. I got myself distracted. 13. I've got some earrings that will look awesome with that necklace I just showed you. So, they're gold. They have sort of the chicken scratch, you know, just little lines on here and here. And then these discs have the beaten metal. Same with the bar right here. And then this one looks just like this one up here, except smaller size. And then this has the beaten metal as well. Okay, so those are number 13. Number 13. Abra, go lay down, please. You know, the dogs will lay around the house all day, not do anything. I get on here and they want to go back and forth, back and forth, back and forth. Number 14. Okay, now this set that I put together for you is a lot of fun. So your free earrings here are these pink seed bead loops. There's two of them and they are crossed. They're on a silver setting. Necklace has a lobster claw and chain extender, and it is a collection of different ropes of pink seed beads. Now, it's not going to look good with the shirt I have on. These look amazing. Here, let me show you on the black. The black would be better, huh? Dancing. And my shirt is not orange. Red. Kind of looks orange on the screen. Look at that. You know, when I first got one of these in my starter set, I didn't think that it would sell. Didn't think anybody would like it. I sold it on my very first show. Now it wasn't pink. It was purple, I think. But this necklace is gorgeous, and you better jump on it before someone else takes it, because it's going to sell. Because it is gorgeous, and it is funky, and funky is in. And if you think I'm wrong, oh, that was 14. Think I'm wrong, you just wait. Just wait. It's in. Number 15. I have these fishhook earrings for you. They're on a silver setting. I got a bright pink stone right there, smack dab in the middle. And it's kind of like a flower. And they would look awesome with that seed bead necklace. Okay, and I'm going to go backwards. Those are number 15. Number 15. Number 16, this isn't new, it is relatively new. I have two of these available. It is a leather wrap. Let me show you. I should use this. Okay, so you have a round bead over here. See the little holes? Then you got this silver barrel bead. And it's got like a tribal pattern on it. Then you got a pink bead. And then you got this center bead right here. It has a flower on it. The same on the other side. Now these are super cool. Which strand is there? Oh, and it's got another barrel bead on either end. I have to show you. And I don't think you want to sit here while I unwrap that. So, of course, you can tie it around your neck. You can drape it around your neck like one of those scarves. So, use this as a prop. Okay, so you can tie it as a choker. Like that, and you can double knot it and put in a bow, or you can just let the ends drape over. Or, come here. You can hang a little lower and drape, or tie in a bow. You can put this in your hair. Tie it around your ponytail. You can wear it as a headband, you know, a little jaunty headband. You can also twist this around your wrist and wear it as a bracelet. You know, you just tuck the ends in, just like that. Of course, you're going to want to twist it so that's in the front, not in the back. And I've done it so tight that I can't twist it around on my hand. Or you can put it around your ankle. You can wear it as the anklet. So it is very cool. Don't work with a belt like the other one does. So, extremely versatile. Necklace, choker, hair accessory, hair decoration, anklet. The possibilities are possibly pretty much endless. Okay, so that one is number 16. And I have two of those available. Count them. Two. Okay, now this ring here, it is a lighter color pink. It's more of a, it's lighter. You got a silver, stretchy back, medium. And then on the front, you have that lighter. Not gonna focus. Usually, if I have a card back here, it'll focus. Come on. Pretend you like me, telephone. It doesn't like me. Okay, it focused for a second. So, you have the top band here. Has arrows on it. And then you got your pink stone here in the middle. And the bottom one here is just circles. The same metal that the ring is made of. Just a little raised. So that is number 17. Okay, number 18 here, you have your free earrings. They are purple seed bead loops. These ones do not intersect. They lay right on top of each other. Necklace has a lobster claw chain extender. And I think it's almost at its shortest right now. Yeah. You got these silver beads. They start out small and they get bigger, and they're the same on both sides. And it comes down into this braided rope of purple seed beads. And that is number 18. Number 18. Hello. Hi, Tammy. Number 19. I have this leather wrap for you. It's silver snaps, two snaps for the sizing, and then it's got a braid of purple leather covered in silver rhinestones. And look about like that on. Lighter than the purple on the necklace, but I think it would match well. 19. Number 20. This ring here has a small silver stretchy back. And on the front, we got this large purple stone. And it is surrounded by these small white rhinestones. That is number 20. Your free earrings on this necklace. These light purple stones. They are faceted in an oval shape. The necklace has a lobster claw and chain extender. And it comes down into this collection of more of those light purple stones, also faceted, in different shapes and sizes. So you got ovals in the middle, circles along the top row, and on the bottom, you got the pear-shaped one or teardrop-shaped one with circle ones in between. And that is number 21. Tangled itself up on there. Okay, I think besides the lanyard, that's all the new stuff I have up on for today. Let me show you this one, number 22. This one is new. I have three available. So you have, it's silver, oh, gunmetal, that's the color I'm looking for. Gunmetal snaps, three different sizes. And then you've got a gunmetal square, white stitching, gunmetal square, and then it's blank, and then it repeats itself on the other side. See how tiny my wrists are? They're super tiny. That it's that loose on the smallest setting. Look about like that on. Again, I have three of them available. It is in that dark brown leather. It smells like it. That is number 22. Okay, now we're going to save the other new piece a little bit longer. Break it up for you. You want to see all the new stuff? You got to stay till the end. Well, close to it. 23. Your free earrings on this necklace are these gold tassel earrings. The necklace does have the lobster claw and chain extender. And it comes down into this white, I'm going to call it pearlescent because it's got that shine on there that you see on pearls. Flat disc. So with gold lining. And you got the lanyard hanging from it. Now these are great. And it's on a really delicate chain. They're great if you got to have an ID badge for work. Or like I've been telling the younger generation, if you're going to a club or something and you're not going to have pockets, driver's license. And the first time you order a lanyard from me, I will give you an ID holder. 23. I probably should have brought one over here to show you, but I didn't. It's just a plastic case that you can put your driver's license in. And you could put a card in there if you wanted to. And I skipped a whole row. Go back to that one later. So the first time you order a lanyard from me, I will give you an ID holder to go with it. 24. Only the first time. You've got to use the same ID holder for all the lanyards you buy. These earrings right here. So they got this little flower looking thing at the top with the, it looks like rope twisted up in there. Note this reminds me of, it reminds me of quilling. My sister-in-law does quilling. And it looks like the little flowers that she would quill out of paper. You got a white bead here, a larger white bead right there, and these are just flat silver little discs with no design in them hanging from there. That is number 24. This is a memory wrap lace bracelet. I had two, sold one. You can wear this as a bracelet, an anklet, or you can put it around your hair. It starts out on this end with five white beads, but you got five silver beads, rocker bar. There's a lot more white beads there. Anyway, you get the idea. It goes white, silver, silver, white, silver, silver, all the way around. So you just open it up. It's like that. Wrap it around. And that is number 25. Don't have any room up there. I think my table shrunk overnight. So I'm gonna get filling sometimes with their stuff just shrinks. 26. This ring has a medium stretchy back. And then on the front, again, you got those little designs. It's not the same as the earrings, but it matches pretty well, I think. And you got three white stones. And you got that design on both sides. And that is number 26. I'm going to match those earrings beautifully. If I do say so myself. Number 26. Now we're going to go back one. Because I accidentally skipped one. This is one of the newer pieces that I have. 27. First debut on live. So you have these medium purple beads for your earrings. The necklace has a lobster claw chain extender. The links have these little lines on to make them look like rope. And then you come down into this collection of beads. So you get a purple one up here. You got this one that kind of looks like a planet, maybe. This is a clear, smooth, not clear, a smooth I'm going with silver. You got a clear faceted purple bead here. And this one is silver and it's got little raised circles all over it. And you got those holes in there. And you got this large purple bead. And then it just the same way up the other side. Twenty-eight. We have these earrings for you here. So you start out and you got white rhinestone, white rhinestone. You got the purple bead right there in the middle that dangles. And you got a white rhinestone here, 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 and here. And then you got the purple beads, obviously, dangling from the bottom. Okay, and those are number 28. Number 28. There's my drink. Found it. It's okay. Nobody panic. I'm going to make it this ring right here. It's got a medium stretchy back. And on the front, it's just these silver lines. And they've got some decoration on them. Let's see if I can get it to focus. Mm-hmm. There you go. See it? That is number 29. Number 29 on that silver ring. Number 30. I have this collection of silver bangles for you. This is on the smaller side. I can get it on, but it's not exactly comfortable. It's held together by this metal bar, this metal barbell in silver. And they're not smooth. So they kind of got that frosted look to them. And there are 5 of them. So, it's snug. Once I get it on, it's not too bad. I better get used to it. Looks about like that. Hey! No! Excuse me, the dog is stealing my stuff. Let go. Let go. Coda? Mickey? Yeah? Get the Coda out of my room, please. She's stealing stuff off my bed, and I'm trying to do my show. Sorry about the interruption, guys. I neglected to put my cross-stitch stuff up. It's number 30. I just left it on the bed so I could do it when I was done with this. And our new puppy, Dakota, decided that my embroidery thread would make a good chew toy. And tried to run off with a bunch of it. Now, it wouldn't have been such a big deal if it wasn't a kit. See, a kit comes with a certain number of threads. And they don't have DMC numbers, so it's not like I can go to the store and just buy more of that color. That's part of the reason I don't like kits. But what I really wanted to work on was a birth announcement for my nephew, whose girlfriend just had a baby. But I couldn't find all the DMC numbers that I need in my stash, which sucks because I know I have them because my wonderful husband bought me the complete set of DMC threads. I think it was the year before last. So I've put them somewhere and I don't know where, and I need to find it because the baby has been born and I have not even started the birth sampler yet. 31. I'm a great aunt. My sister is a grandmother. Is that crazy or what? Okay, so this necklace right here starts out with your free earrings. There are these copper beads. The necklace has a lobster claw and chain extender. I have no pictures yet, though. This is a lanyard. So, again, if you're a first time buying a lanyard, I will give you an ID holder for free to hang on the bottom of this. You put your work ID in. You could put driver's license, card, whatever you want to put in there. So we got these rope circles right here. Silver bead. This one reminds me of potato chip. Silver bead. Another rope circle. This side has a rope circle. Copper bead. These 4 copper circles that are independent of each other. Potato chip thingy. And another rope circle. Comes down into 3 chains, 2 of which are naked. 1 has the lanyard hook on it. You're gonna fit about like that. It's gonna look great. Great, great, great. That is number 31. Lanyard. Now, since I like to try and show you at least one thing that could go with any necklace, because some people, you know, they need help picking out stuff that matches. This doesn't match. No, I don't like the way that looks together. I don't really have anything to match that right now. I will get something eventually. And then you better believe I will be showing it to you. 32. Okay, so your free earrings here are these small, faceted, almost silver beads. The necklace has a lobster claw and chain extender. So it's identical on both sides. We got a small silver bead there, stretch a chunky chain, a large faceted clear bead, and it's the same way on the other side. And then we come down into three chains. The thinnest of the chains has tiny silver beads on, clear beads on it every so often. Then you got a slightly thicker chain. It has a kink in it. And it's naked. And then we have the thickest chain. And that one is the one that has the lanyard on it. I have two of these available. Gonna sit about like that. Number 32. Tonight I have paired that with this bracelet. It does have the lobster claw and chain extender. If you buy a chain extender for your chain extender, you can turn it into an anklet. It is covered in these little flowers. They have a white rhinestone in the middle. There we go. That is number 33. Number 33. Yes, I didn't do anything today. Little housework. Tried to watch a movie, but internet's stupid. Watch some videos on Facebook. Housework. Got the kids started on cleaning their room. We'll see how well they did later. I haven't checked yet. I should have checked. But I didn't check yet. Cleaned up after the dog. The puppy that is not house trained yet. Number 34. This one has a small stretchy back. And then on the front, the top row is oval-shaped rhinestones. And the middle row has little tiny circle rhinestones. And that is number 34. Number 35. Your free earrings. This one are these wavy silver ovals. And I'm pretty sure I had two of these. I sold the other one though. Lobster clock, chain extender. And then we've got a collection of ovals in different size. Again, they're smooth but wavy. And the ovals are connected by double links. We come down and we have three chains. And there's no decoration on any of the chains except for your lanyard. Again, if it's your first time ordering a lanyard, I will give you an ID holder. It's going to hang about like that. And that is number 35. The next piece I have for you, 36, is another one of those leather tuck wraps that I showed you. The exact same as the pink one, except we got brown beads this time. Remember, it can be a necklace, it can be a choker, it can be a hair accessory, it can be a bracelet, it can be an anklet. There are so many uses for this type of bracelet. They're extremely versatile. I have two of these available. And that is number 36. Notice I found my numbers? Mm-hmm. They weren't really that hard to find. 37. Okay, this ring has a medium stretchy back. And then on the front, we have a silver wavy line. Silver wavy lines. Smooth. And match well with those ovals, though. And that is number 37. I'm not sure why I had those wraps out. They're not, maybe. I know why I was so confused. I don't know. Number 38, your free earrings on here are these tiny black seed beads. The necklace has a lobster claw and chain extender. And we're going to put this one on the thing. On the thing it goes. Okay, so you got your black beads here, and then you got these leaves in various sizes. Very cool. And that's going to be number 38. Number 39, I only have one of these left available, so if you want it, you better jump on it now. It's the same as the other two that I've shown you, except we got black beads instead of the brown or the pink. Remember what I said, bracelet, anklet, choker, necklace, hair accessory, the possibilities are endless on this. Collect them all in each color. Number 39. Supposed to have a blue one coming. And it is gorgeous. Bright blue. Okay, let's continue with the theme of black. We already showed you a bracelet for that one. Let's show you a ring for that one. I only have one black ring because that one's purple, I think. Either purple or dark red. I think it's purple though. Okay. So this one has a medium stretchy back. Oh, number 40, medium stretchy back. And on the front, we got that large black stone. What's up for those dog bones? Okay, and the decoration, the lines on the silver bars above and below the black stone, when you get close, they kind of look like little dog bones. Number 40. And this is, yeah, knuckle to knuckle. Which isn't as annoying as you might think. Because it doesn't, you know, if it was back here, knuckle to knuckle, that might get annoying because you can only bend your finger so far. But it being back here, it doesn't restrict your movement at all. So, not as annoying as you might think. Alright, number 41. You have these large black beads for your earrings. Little flowers on the bottom of them. Chunky black beads for your earrings. Necklace has a lobster claw chain extender. You have silver beads, black, silver, faceted silver, black. You got a washer here. And this bead is just like the one on your free earrings. And you get two different washers. This one's smooth, kind of wavy. And this one sort of has lines on it. It's hard to see though. Then you got this black and silver speckled bead. Another washer, black bead, double washer, black and silver. This is as short as it gets, so it's only going to get longer with the chain extender. And that is number 41. Number 41. Almost dropped it. And as we discovered the other day when the dogs knocked over the board, you do not want to drop things. Things will get broken. They don't like to be dropped that far when they're that high up. Alright, I chose some earrings to show with this. Number 42. They are these hoops. They are in a gunmetal color. It's going to match well with that black. Silver rhinestones on the front until about halfway. And then they start on the inside halfway all the way to the back. They're not very heavy. They're going to hang about like that. Number 43. Now, some of this stuff is part of what they call a blockbuster line, which means it doesn't sell out because they just keep making more. But I can't remember which ones are blockbuster and which ones are not. Maybe I need to color code them. That'd be a lot of work, though. That would be a lot of work. Okay. I'm going to show you this leather wrap here next. 44. Black, silver snaps, two snaps for sizing, and it is covered in these silver rhinestones. Look about like that on. Okay. That is number 45. I'm not sure that's the number I started this piece with. But that's the piece where, that's the number we're ending the piece with. Okay. I'll show you this string with it. What do you think? Okay. 44 has a medium silver back, and it is covered in these black flowers that are lined with silver. Black and silver, that would look good with those speckled beads, right? Number 44. I don't know where all my peeps are today. I usually always have at least one person watching. But nobody's here. No, don't do that. I'm gonna share it again. Because I don't mean like that. Okay. I remember where I was. Okay. Go there, you're on the way there. 42. Got these black oval beads for your free earrings. The necklace has a lobster claw chain extender, and it comes down into this pendant here. Round pendant, you have a large round black bead in the middle, or stone, and then these black stones around the edge are oval shaped. They kind of have a matte finish, not a whole lot of gloss on them. Longer one, gonna hang about like that. Number 42. We have these earrings here for you. They are on a silver setting fish hook. We have these clear gray beads on there. And we do have the corners are rounded off, so there's not sharp corners on them. You get lots of shine in those faceted stones. They're super light. Gonna hang about like that. And those are number 46. Number 46. Number 47. This one is new. I've never shown it on here before. It is a bracelet. It has the lobster claw and chain extender. You have a silver bar on either side of this oval, clearish gray bead stone. Faceted. Going to give you lots of shine. And that is number 47. Hello, hello, hello. Say hello so I know who's watching me. Don't be stalkerish. Nobody likes a stalker. I don't want a stalker. 48. Have another long necklace for you here. Black, small black faceted beads for your earrings. Silver fishhooks. Necklace, I think this is one, yeah. Necklace does not have a lobster claw chain extender. That's okay though, because it's long enough to fit around your neck without any. So you got a silver bead on a black bead and silver bead. You got this circle here with like the rope decoration that reminds me of potato chips. Another silver circle, silver bead, black bead, and it's the same on the other side. No cat. Then you got another circle here. Silver bead, black bead. Then this is the cool part, this little dangly tassel, right? So let's get up close and personal and look at what we got on this dangly tassel. We have a clear faceted bead. We have a black faceted bead. That chain is naked. We got a large chain. It is also naked. This one has a circle on it, just like you'd find in the necklace. This one has a heart on it, striped. And this one is my favorite. It has a moon, and you can see his face. He has facial features, you know, you can see his eye, his nose, and his mouth. And he's got a striped hat on. If I was doing a project for a baby that said something about a moon, I think I'd buy this necklace just so I could take that moon charm off and put it on there. Number 49. These aren't new, but they are relatively new. So they're circles, and they have more of those clear silver beads on there. They're in, I don't know what shape it is. I'm not a shape ideas. Teardrop shape, that's what it is. And give you lots of bling on your ears. They're super, super duper light. They're going to hang about like that. And they are gorgeous. Remember, everything is lead and nickel free. Everything is $5 plus tax and shipping. Although, if you are family and you want to feed me, I'll come down and visit you and I'll pay shipping. Although, you lose because food's more expensive, but you get to see me. 49 on those earrings. Beautiful. All right. Next, number 50. I am going to show you this leather wrap. Silver snaps, two snaps for sizing. It's just like the purple one, except this time in black. with her. I thought there was something broken with it, but there's not. Did I give you a number? And I have 3 of these beauties available. Number 50. Any teen would love to have this. Surprised my daughter hasn't claimed one yet. She's probably feeling kind of guilty about the jewelry she has claimed and unpaid for. And that is number 50. Okay. I like this necklace. I think it is so neat. You got these itty bitty little black beads for your free earrings. Necklace has a lobster claw and chain extender. It is a double chain, one delicate, one slightly thicker. The thicker one has more of those beads hanging off it like you'd find in your necklace or your free earrings. And the thinner one, which is also the longer one, has this black pendant hanging from it. Super simple. Gonna go with anything. Probably a great one if you like to layer. And that is number 51. We have this stretchy gunmetal bracelet. It's covered with these silver discs that have been beaten metal look with the beads in between each one. Number 52.
Oops.
Lanyards are getting them all away. If I had infinite space. But I don't. It's gotta be slightly overlapping sometimes because I don't have infinite space. I wish I had infinite space. I'll make enough money to buy pegboards. Cover the wall with stuff. Give me a stand. Stand up and do this. Walk around. Pace. 53. And this one. Okay, so your free earrings here. Kind of looks black now. I thought they were different color before. These small black beads. Necklace has a lobster claw chain extender. It is a copper chain. And it comes down into this pendant. Square in shape. Copper tassels hanging from the bottom. And you got the round pendant in the middle. With this large black round stone. Surrounded by these smaller black round stones. It is a long one. Gonna hang about like that. And that is number 53. And I tell you, after I get enough to cover that wall with boards, peg boards, and get me my phone stand so I can stand up and do my shows. Then I'm going to buy me one of those dressmaker busts. Show the things on instead of these little things I got to keep picking up and moving and holding. And yeah. It's going to be awesome. 54 of these copper earrings for you here. Lots of scroll work in between there. Beautiful. Look at those. Aren't those gorgeous? They're gonna hang about like that. Super light. They are gorgeous. They're so beautiful. Those are going to be number 54.
Number 54.
Okay. Last item of the night tonight, I think number 55. This is new, never before seen on live. We have, let's see, brass snaps. Three snaps for siding. It is a light brown leather, very soft, and it's not stiff like most leather is. You get these little brass. Snaps here, top and bottom. I don't know what they are. They're flat on the back, but it's not like they snap in anything. You got the white cording laced down the sides. Then you got this leather. Oh, that's what those snaps are. They're holding the leather in. Little straps and weaving. You braid it in there like that. This is part of the Urban line, so it's going to be larger, but girls can still wear it. And I've learned from my nephew that men can have small wrists that look dainty. He said he needed large leather wraps to make his wrists look more manly. So if you think your wrists look a little girly, men, put a leather wrap on it. It makes them look manly. What I was told by a boy. So that is number 55. And I think that's going to be it for tonight. If any of you were actually here, I'd ask you. Anything you want to see? Push your nose. Anyway, I'll leave this open for replay shopping until 10 p.m. tomorrow. That is 10 p.m. Thursday Mountain Standard Time. Today is Wednesday. Not 10. 7. 7 p.m. Lying to you. Shouldn't do that. Bad. No lying. This video will also go up on YouTube, so if you know somebody who you think would like something I've shown tonight, send them to my YouTube channel. If you don't know where to find it, private message me. I will share you a link. It'll take you directly to the page. It takes a while to upload videos, though, so probably won't be up till later tonight or tomorrow morning. I hope everyone has a good rest of their night and a good Thursday, and I will see you all on Friday at 10 p.m. on Instagram. My beautiful boy. I can't convince him that men wear jewelry, huh? Good night, guys.